We're here in a quarry in North Oxfordshire, trying to uncover these fantastic dinosaur footprints. Back in the Jurassic, there would have been this sticky, wet mud in a lagoon some dinosaurs walked through. They've left their prints behind and they've been preserved as rock and they've been exposed. And this gives us this fantastic opportunity to find out more about these ancient animals. Your traditional fossils are evidence of the death of that animal, and this is evidence of the life of the animal. It was actually walking across this mud. It's this unique glimpse into the life of these animals.
The largest trackways that we've got are from an animal called a sauropod, which is the herbivorous, long-neck, long-tail, large animals. And then we also have megalosaur tracks. So megalosaur is a theropod dinosaur, and they are bipedal, so they walk on two legs, carnivorous, meat-eating animals. So we've got a real ecosystem here. The footprint next to me here is the furthest back that we've got of the theropod, the megalosaur. So it actually goes in this direction, and we can trace mostly both the left and right footprints. A couple of them are missing, which is really bizarre. Presumably it stood on a rock that happened to be there. You know, there are so many ways you can interpret a missing footprint. Not much further on is where this megalosaur track actually crosses over the sauropod trackway. And that's a really exciting interaction between the two animals. So I love to think of the body fossils that we have at the museum. Maybe could they possibly have come from this animal? Probably not, but it's possible.
What's special about what we have here is just how big an area and just how many prints we've got. There are literally hundreds of individual footprints from at least four different types of dinosaur that we can see. And it's that extent that makes this place really, really special.
So behind me, we've got lots of people working extremely hard. It's really important to digitize and document as much as we possibly can.
So we're taking close-up photographs, we're doing photogrammetry, also doing drone imaging to try and get the whole extent of the site, because ultimately this will be reburied, so we won't be able to get access again. So we want to document as much as we can in every way that we can. These kinds of sites are so rare, and to get so many prints, yeah, it absolutely is a dream come true for us.
I would say this is definitely the kind of thing that paleontologists dream of. The trackways that we've got here are extensive. As I say, they're more than one animal, but they're also more than one age of animal. So yeah, pretty much a dream.